It is Saturday, the 29th of April. I'm not going to do a long video today because we're only here to do the fence, and also the battery's not brilliant, it's quite low. So I have just had the most fun smashing this fence up. Give me a mallet and I'm off. It was great fun. So we're going to put in the rest of these posts today, set them in, and then we've got fencing to put up in front of it. It's only like galvanised wire for now. But now we've got this down and all the pallets aren't around, I'm going to do some more weeding down here, get this sorted. Then we can plant the rhubarb and all that here. I'm going to take all the old fence to the tip. And this area is actually looking like it might be a working area soon. So this is the last bit really to do. There was some weeding, so that was so much fun to smash up. Okay, right. I might do a shot later to show you us putting the fence in, show you how we do it. It's really straightforward, but it might be helpful for some people. So, yeah, catch up with you soon. Right, it is Saturday, we're still here. We've done cemented in two posts, and we've got two more to go. This one is higher than the others, because it just would not go down any deeper. So what we did is we took a line from the post that's set in on the gate there all the way down to the post that's set in on this corner, so that we knew that they were all straight. Then we're using this fence post cement. So basically you dig your hole and then you add, it says no mix, so ideally you should be able to just add your water, then your cement, and leave it. But we found that that makes it's not, doesn't set perfectly, does it? So what we do is we add a bit of the cement powder, then some water, mix it slightly, and then top up with a little bit more water and a little bit more cement, and mush that around, and it sets within 15 minutes. So you put some water in there, and I will add some more cement in a minute. He's going to mix it first, just to make sure that water gets down. We found that if you put the water in first and then the cement, it doesn't actually seep down to the bottom, and it just doesn't firm in properly. So you do that and then top up with cement and mush that round again. When that sets, it will look like so. And this was a big hole, we backfilled this hole so that literally just underneath the surface there is actually all mud. But we did it to there, and we did it about an inch below the surface so we can fill this back with dirt, and it doesn't look like a big whacking fence post hole. This was done 10 minutes ago and it's solid. So that's, you know, you can see it's still wet down here, but that is a solid fence post, and that's 10 minutes. So that's what we use. I know a lot of allotments don't allow cement, but that's the secretary recommended it for these, so don't know why we're allowed, but we are. Maybe we've got a special exemption because we're awesome. Or it may be because we're actually moving site in a few years and he don't care, does he? So he's added a bit more in there and mixed it in a bit more. I'm going to do this one and I'm not going to talk much. Don't breathe the cement powder in. That'll do. Now, by doing this in two stages, by doing the bottom bit and mixing it a bit and then doing the top layer, what this will do is ensure that it has gone right down to the base and it is secure. Now, we are going to put a mesh fence on here, so it's not going to have any wind barrier as such. It's not going to be affected by that. the wind will travel through it quite easily, so they shouldn't get any resistance and feel like they're going to come down. But it's always good to be secure, because what we might do is actually from the ground level up to, say, here, so about a foot and a half, maybe 2 foot, we might actually use pallet wood to go between, so it's more of a firm structure on the bottom and then the wire higher up, which would be more of a deterrent for rabbits and whatnot. And whatnot? Al hates it when I say that. There you go, Alan's just finishing the last bit up in that one. And then that'll be done, and we are going to go sit up there and have something to eat while these last two set, and then we can put in the mesh and be done. And I'm going to go home and sulk. I'm going to walk up and I'll tell you why I'm sulking. So the secretary has spoken to the guy on the next plot. I think I said in my last video that he was seeing if he was still interested, because he hadn't done anything. The secretary spoke to him and said, are you still interested in having your plot, because you've not been here since the start of February? And I'm not going to turn around and show you his plot because it seems a bit rude now, but looks like he said yes, because nothing's really changed, but they've been and taken some of the weeds out of the greenhouse, and that's it. So I was pretty excited at the thought of us having first refusal of that plot. And I had all these plans in my head, but, you know, it wasn't meant to be. It's not my plot anyway. I can't get down about that. But then I got offered a greenhouse, which I was going to put here. So this flower bed would be moved and it would go a bit further down that way. So it would be set here. And then I was pipped at the post with that, because the person who was supposed to be collecting it didn't come with the right tools, and then she said I could have it, and then she said they're coming back with better tools, and then she gave it to them. And then today I saw another one, and because we literally, our car still isn't fixed, because we couldn't get there right away, we were told that we can't have it. We could have gone and started it tonight but not finished it, but apparently that's not good enough and he's given it to someone else, which is fine and it's fair. But I'm sulking because our car's still not fixed, and I just, yeah, I'm a bit grumpy today. Right, I'm going to do this very quickly and very quietly because we're at somebody's house. But this is my greenhouse, complete with the benches. It's just one broken pane here, and I've got paraffin heater and everything. So we're going to take this apart now. It might take us some time, but I am so happy, so excited right now. It's an 8x6 and it's going to be great. So I'm going to get on with that. We have got the roof out and the front out. The whole thing comes with these little clips. Focus, it won't focus because of the glass. On each joint there's these clips. You simply, using fine nose pliers, just pop out. They're very easy to get out, and so you apparently can get them in them packs from Wilkinson's, and that very cheap, so we need quite a few, so lots of them in the originals. Label every single pane, and on some of the panes I've even gone so far as to draw on which panel it is, so this is the side and then that's this panel. It's going well, only one breakage so far, and it was only a tiny corner piece, so not the end of the world. So yeah, going well, exciting. There's mare's tail here in there, can you see it? That stuff scares me. I'm really hoping that by some chance it doesn't come back with us, it tries to jump in our bag or something. Right, I'm gonna carry on. Bye. Voila. Right, it's done. Got it down. Measuring to see if these side panels will fit in the car without us taking them apart. If you can't get this base bit up, it's concreted down, so we'll have to get a different base system for ours, but that's not a problem. All looks good. I think Alan broke four pieces, but they're all only little bits, so not the end of the world. So now we've got to speed home fast because I've got to take my mum to the shops and then we can go up the plot. Woohoo! Hi guys, we are up the plot now. We're not staying long, we've just come to investigate this because we got collared by the treasurer of the plot yesterday, and the guy who has this side, so there's a full plot on this side, a full plot on that side, and the guy who has this side has now decided, after we spoke to the committee about the fact that he hasn't cleared up any of this glass here, that's all from his greenhouse, and we was concerned that it was going to get overgrown by weeds, and also that these weeds here were getting very long and blowing over to ours. So it turns out that the guy doesn't want the plot. Well, what he wants is his half. So from there, across that way. And all of this is ours. We get this. So I'll give you a quick tour. So we get the cherry tree. I'm really, really excited about that. There's going to be lots of cherries this year. We've got two really big, gorgeous comfrey plants. So I've been making myself some comfrey tea. The rhubarb technically sits on my side, because it's this side of the cherry tree. It's gone to flower. I've never seen a rhubarb in flower before. Very beautiful. Now, if it's gone to flower, this may seem a very silly question to some, but can I still eat it? Like, there's some lovely good stems in there. Am I okay to eat those still? I'm sure I am. I just can't eat the flower heads, can I? Some lovely little new stems as well. And then we've got plenty of raspberries across the back. Never IBC. And then we've got all these pots. I'm really chuffed because there's a whole load of root trainers, which is perfect because we're planting our beans tomorrow. So they are coming home with us. If I grab those, I'll what else have we got down here? Exploring it. Lots of trays and smaller pots. Loads of pots in here as well. What did you find? She's all the way down the bottom. More things over here. Great, little treasure trove of bits and bobs. There's all stuff underneath in there as well. Tassel needs sorting out. It's a bit spiky. So there we've got here, this ground up to the path. I'm not sure what we're going to plan yet. As I was saying, the memory card is full. Because this side is ours, we're going to measure up from the fruit trees down to the fruit down there, and then we can plan out what we're going to plant here.
Look what I found. I found in our shed.
You found money?
In our shed.
How lucky are you? You're going to keep that?
Yeah.
Okay, now what do you do? See that piece of wood there?
Yeah, I know.
That's the barrier. You do not go over it. Stay on this side. Cool. Okay, so. And we've got this fruit tree. Is anybody good with fruit trees? Any ideas what this might be? I'm thinking maybe apple. Really nice if it was a pear, but I don't think it is. So we've got that. If we come down here, as we come down, we've inherited the incinerator, so now we can give our one back that we borrowed. Lots of gooseberries. There's lots of weeding to do around here. This has been really overgrown. There's 3 or 4 gooseberry bushes, I think, which will please my dad, for my dad loves gooseberries. Lovely. Some more. Oh, look at that. Lovely rhubarb. I'm going to take some of this home tonight and give this to my mum, because she is going to make us a rhubarb crumble for Beltane or May Day tomorrow, so that'll be really nice and fresh. I walk around. I've got these frames that are actually going to be really useful, and we use all those. Oh, there's a hole there. Oops. Loads of raspberries coming up here. You see, All these are raspberries. Lots of weird. No, these are raspberries. These are autumn raspberries coming up now. Okay. The summer raspberries are already big and tall and fruiting. The autumn raspberries are small and just coming up. Or is that the other way around? Or vice versa? I can never tell. This is going to be more of a challenge than our plot. Our plot was pretty much clear. Not going to be a lot of work, but still nice. Lots of currant and raspberries over here too, which I don't know. I think we're going to be inundated with fruit this year. I think I'll be giving it away or begging people to take it. So if we look through there, where Al is, pretty much here down is ours. So that technically means that the shed is ours. Now, I was told, definitely is because it's only small, I was told we have to take the shed down because you can only have one shed per plot. Now that's my plot. This plot's in Alan's name. So I'm going to ask if we can keep the shed or at least put a new one there because it'll be really good. If we want this wildlife pond there. There's lots of flowers coming up here. It'd be really nice to have this as a little wildlife hide and storage place and all things in place for Roo to play. I'll ask anyway. But these are his slabs. I'm assuming he's going to move them. I've got to try and talk to him, but I've never ever seen him. So I'm going to put a notice like just inside his greenhouse with my contact details on, and we can write notes to each other. And this was his shed that was on the floor here. So I've cleared that up. I don't know where he's going to put the shed. I hope he doesn't put it like slap bang in the middle over there and it casts loads of shade. But it's not up to me, is it? So then we got a little pond. It doesn't look so pretty with all these the knapweed and forget-me-nots around it. Now there were frogs in here. I don't know where they are now. No, they couldn't get out, so I actually put a piece of wood in to help them out. So the first thing I'm going to do is clean this a little bit and then put the there's little bees over there. And I'm going to put the weeds on the side so that they can get back in if there's any little animals in there. So there you go. It's so pretty. So this is our half plot. Oh, we've got these two trees here too. This one has been pruned with an inch of its life this year. I don't think we'll get anything off that. But this one looks good. Again, don't know what it is. If anyone has any ideas, let me know. Has it got any blossom on it? It's not got any blossom on it at all. Interesting. Okay, so there's our plot and Alan's plot. Lots of planning to be done. Oh, and our potatoes coming up. Potatoes. So we've been earthing those up. I'll probably leave them now. Or maybe another earthing up and then leave them. And our greenhouse. It's going to go somewhere up here. Where do you think? See, I was going to move the flower bed and put it across here. It's 8x6, but it's 8 on the front, like the long way, rather than being 8x6 like his one, which is narrow at the front and long down the side. This is long down the front and narrow. It's about the same size as this bed, isn't it? Yeah? I could put it there, or I could put it in front of there. Or I could put it over there. Or over there. Spoilt for choice. But I think it might go here. Do you think? Yeah, might go there. Okay, so I'm going to go pick some rhubarb, take some measurements, make some plans, and then Al's got to go back and get the last bits of the greenhouse. We couldn't fit them all in the car in one go. It's been a busy weekend, a fantastic weekend. I'm really, really chuffed to get that extra half plot. The only challenge is going to be communicating with him to make sure that I'm not annoying him, he's not annoying me. So yeah, until next time, bye bye. See ya.